1984 was a very special year for 130 young men and women who came together from 18 different countries to form Up With People's Cast E. They met each other for the first time on January 16th in Tucson, Arizona, where Up With People has its head office. Canyon Del Oro High School on the edge of the Santa Catalina Mountains hosted the young people of Cast E for the 4 weeks they spent rehearsing and staging their show and preparing for an exciting year of travel, learning, giving, and sharing their lives with others. The new cast was given a warm welcome by Jay Blanton Belk, president of Up With People.
Listen, very briefly, I want to say how glad I am you're here, and I want to congratulate you for coming. I know some of you spent a lot of time raising your tuition. Still raising it. You've worked hard to get here, and you deserve to be here. Also, you're part of Up With People, not just part of Cast E, and that's an important thing, isn't it? Think about that. Now, you probably don't know this morning, but there are four other casts out there on the road thinking about you, and I might just very briefly tell you where they are. Do you know where they are this morning? It's a good exercise to constantly think, where are the other casts? I'll tell you why it's a good exercise. If you're always thinking about where is this global organization of Up With People that's encouraging understanding among people of all the countries of the world, where are they this morning? If you keep living that way this year, next year when you leave us, and the years after for the rest of your life, maybe you'll live always in a global community. How about that? Because you're an age that is a global community.
On February 14th, the cast boarded their buses and struck out on their international odyssey. In Arizona, they participated in Autumn Tush, the Indian Day's festivities in Casa Grande, then traveled on into New Mexico, Colorado, Wyoming, Montana, Idaho, and Oregon, and in June, finished their first semester in Yakima, Washington. While Cast E was making its way through the western states, Cast C was on tour in Italy. On the morning of July 1st, 1984, Cast E was in Boston, Massachusetts, preparing for their concert that night with the Boston Pops Esplanade Orchestra. The five international casts of Up With People perform in more than 450 communities in at least 15 countries throughout the world each year. Highlight performances during 1983 and 1984 so far have taken place in Belfast, Northern Ireland, at the Silver Dome near Detroit, Michigan, and on the steps of St. Peter's Cathedral in Rome. But there's no audience in the world quite like the one in Massachusetts that comes by the thousands every summer to the Esplanade along the Charles River to enjoy their beloved Boston Pops Orchestra. Up With People's castee was invited to perform with the Boston Pops on July 1st, 1984. More than 30,000 people were there, and the music and the images speak for themselves.
Welcome to the Esplanade. We're the international cast of Up With People, and I'm Prima from Malaysia. It's great to be here in Boston, and a privilege for us to perform with the Boston Pops Orchestra, conducted by Harry Ellis Dixon.
Following Boston, the cast spent a month in New England and then was on its way across the Atlantic. Half of them went to Germany, while the other half flew directly from New York to Jordan, where they spent a week performing at the internationally renowned Jerash Festival of Culture and Arts.
Yeah. herzlich an Up With People.
On August 19th, the cast was reunited in Wiesbaden, Germany, and launched into their European tour that carried them through Germany, Sweden, Finland, Denmark, the Netherlands, and Belgium. In Germany, Cast E appeared on several national TV shows, including Telecircus and ZDF's New Year's Eve extravaganza. The ancient city of Jerash nestles in the hills of Gilead, 30 miles northwest of Amman in Jordan. In 200 AD, Jerash was a thriving commercial center on the eastern frontier of the Roman Empire. Today, one can still walk the chariot-rutted streets lined with hundreds of columns which support delicately carved Ionic and Corinthian capitals. In August 1984, the annual Jerash Festival of Culture and Arts was held under the patronage of Their Majesties King Hussein and Queen Noor. On the initiative of Dr. Landrum Bowling and the Jordan Society, Up With People was invited to participate in the festival, along with performing groups from the Middle East, Europe, North and South America. The 45-member cast, representing 12 countries, was flown to Jordan on Aliyah, the Royal Jordanian Airlines. On the flight, the cast members met with other passengers from Jordan who helped them learn the words of a popular Jordanian song which was to be featured in their show. Arriving at Jerash, the cast was awestruck at the sight of the 2,000-year-old amphitheater where they would present their show immediately following the opening ceremonies of the festival. The cast quickly set up their stage and equipment, and after rehearsing, gathered backstage to work with students from Yarmouk University, who drilled them on the pronunciation of the Arabic lyrics of the special song they were learning. At 6:30 p.m. on August 17th, King Hussein and Queen Noor entered the ancient forum. The torch was lit, and the festival got underway with singing and dancing by Bedouin dance groups and the Friendship Folklore Troupe from the Soviet Union. Nearly 3,000 people packed the amphitheater for each of the two Up With People performances. Several of the students of Yarmouk University participated in the show by making all the introductions in Arabic. As the cast launched into the Jordanian song midway through their show, the audience, which included three of the king and queen's children, clapped and cheered and demanded an encore.
Stella.
At the end of each show, people rush to the front of the stage to meet the cast.